going on? I hope you are doing well. Today I want to take you along while I cook three meals in one night, which it was not the expectation at all. I was going to cook two things, but turns out I miscalculated how much meat I needed, and now we have this video for your enjoyment and viewing pleasure. Three meals in one night. I guess it's kind of a meal prep video in a way, where I am just cooking three things right this instant, and then I will use these things later on throughout the week before they have expired. So let's just go ahead and get started. So I ended up making three things somehow tonight. I started thinking about making a meatloaf, and I was going to half the meat and make tacos with the other portion of ground beef that was left over from the meatloaf. But when I mixed the meatloaf, I realized there was way too much meat and it would have been too large of a meatloaf. So I just went ahead and made some meatballs that I put in the freezer. They don't really look very attractive, but I promise they are delicious.
So to start for this meatloaf, we are going to be putting all of our dry ingredients in a bowl. So that is what I've done. The center of the screen is where we will start, and then we will go clockwise in order. So that is 2 cups of breadcrumbs. Then you have Parmesan cheese, that's 1 cup. You have 3 teaspoons of paprika, 2 teaspoons of white pepper, 1 teaspoon of black pepper. You have 2 teaspoons of, what is that called? Parsley. Then you have 1 teaspoon of oregano. We have 1 tablespoon of garlic powder. We have 1 tablespoon of onion powder, and then 3 tablespoons of Tony Sachery's Creole seasoning. So what I'm gonna do next is I am going to get my meat, which I am going to use 2.5 pounds meat, and then I'm going to get 3 eggs, and I will mix them all together in a little season and blend also. So some cut up bell pepper, onion, and celery. So I have everything in this bowl ready to be mixed. And after I mix it all very thoroughly, I'm going to add 3 tablespoons of Worcestershire sauce. Pretty sure I didn't say that correctly. So one thing I like doing is trying to cook two things in the same night. That way I have some options for the next few days and I do not have to worry about cooking anything. So I am also going to include a little bit of a bonus feature in this video, and that is how I season my ground beef for a taco style dinner, because it's going to be like tacos, but it's not like your traditional store-bought taco seasoning. A long time ago, I stopped buying the taco seasoning, like the pre-packaged taco seasoning, and I just use the seasonings I have in my cabinet, which I have everything I need on hand because I tend to cook a lot. So this is just going to be a quick, I guess, substitution for a store-bought taco seasoning. So here is the meatloaf all nice and done. I'm not going to put anything on top of it just quite yet. I'm going to let it cook for a little while. But it is ready and I am going to start it. Funny story, the heating element on this oven went out. It's original to the house, which was built in the early 90s. But aside from that meatloaf and this taco meat, I realized I had way too much meat for just a plain meatloaf. It would have been way too large. So I made 3 meals tonight, actually. And this is meatballs that I will put probably in the freezer until these other two things are completely gone. And then I'll make some red sauce for that and we'll have spaghetti and meatballs. Another fun fact, the meatball recipe and meatloaf recipe are really not that far off from each other. And typically my meatball and meatloaf recipe are just about the same. So the last thing I need to do is season this taco meat, and I will get the seasonings and I will show you how it is I make my tacos delicious without a pre-made seasoning pack. So here's all the seasonings that I'm going to be using for the tacos. Really, it's just some basic ingredients that most taco seasoning packs consist of. And then also we have some beef bouillon right here, 2 of them.
The turtle Heard.
Alright, come pour it. So, the last thing I'm going to do is add two of these little pre-crushed garlic pieces into here and then just let it cook down and it will be done. Checking on the meatloaf, almost ready for the topping. So that's everything for this video. I hope you enjoyed it. I hope it gave you some inspiration. I hope the days in front of you are kind and the ones behind you don't haunt you too much. Until next time, I will see you later.